Hey guys, I'm at the Koh Ker Pyramid in Cambodia, and today we are going to look at a mysterious stone technology called Knobs. You see this protrusion here. This is very fascinating to see. Why does it have a projection like a doorknob? If you look at the neighboring blocks, they don't have this protrusion, but this block does. What is the purpose of this knob? Why was it created more than 1,000 years ago? Perhaps you may think this is just an exception. So when I explored this level of the pyramid, this is not the ground level. I'm walking on one of the steps of this stepped pyramid. Again, look at this block. See that block which has a plant growing on top of it. That is a block which has a knob. It clearly has a protrusion, a bump facing outside. Why were these created? What is the purpose of them? Let me show you another temple in India. This is the famous Brihadeeswara Temple in Thanjavur. It is also built around the same time as the Koh Ker Pyramid. This is also at least 1,000 years old. This is also a Shiva temple, and this is also a pyramid. Some fascinating coincidences, even though both of them are separated by 3,000 miles. But perhaps the biggest coincidence is their giant lingams. The lingam at Thanjavur Temple is 13 feet tall from the ground, and it also goes underground for many feet. And remember, I talked about the giant crystal lingam which existed in Koh Ker Pyramid. But let's get back to the mystery of knobs. We're able to see knobs in this temple as well. I shot this in 2013 because it has some very, very intriguing details. This is all solid granite, huge blocks perfectly fit together. You cannot even insert a needle between these blocks. They look as though they were molded and assembled. But look at the knobs. I noticed something strange about how they were set up. If the walls have no carvings or inscriptions, then we can see a lot of knobs. Here, look, you can see a cluster of knobs on these walls. The entire wall is full of blocks with knobs. But if the wall was designated to have carvings or inscriptions, then there are no knobs at all. They're perfectly smooth. The more I observe this, the more I find this to be true. Another fascinating detail. Look at this wall. No knobs at the eye level, but the stones with knobs are used where people would not normally see them. It appears that the stone blocks with knobs were used in unimportant places as though they are defective pieces from a mass manufacturing company. What do I mean by this? Today, let's say you want to build a nice big house and you mass produce 50,000 bricks and you end up with about 500 bricks which are deformed or defective. What would you do? You don't want to throw away 500 bricks, so you would use them in unimportant places or in places where they won't be seen. This is exactly what we see in this temple. The blocks with knobs are used in unimportant places or places where they won't be noticed. And you may think, wow, that's a lot of knobs. But the stone blocks with knobs just make up 1 or 2% of the entire temple. And these knobs are not only found in Cambodia and India, they're found in Egypt, Peru, Turkey, and in almost all ancient megalithic sites. You can see these knobs in any ancient site, even though the purpose of these has been a mystery until now. Mainstream archaeology gives a strange answer to this. Experts say these knobs were cut while the stones were quarried. Why? So they could put ropes underneath the stones and lift them. But when we carefully observe the position of these knobs, many of them are not symmetrical. If you take this stone, for example, and put a rope underneath these knobs, the stone would tip forward or to the side. It won't be well balanced. Many of the knobs are not symmetrical, and it would be impossible to use them for putting ropes underneath and lifting them. A lot of these knobs are also too small. You cannot put ropes underneath this knob, for example. This knob is just too small, even to put your finger underneath and lift it. Archaeologists don't have an answer for this. And then there is another question that should have popped into your head already. If these knobs were cut for the purpose of lifting, then all the stone blocks should have these knobs. But they don't. Why don't all the blocks have these knobs? The mainstream explanation makes no sense. This explanation is quite simply wrong. Let's take a look at it from the engineering perspective. Why were these knobs created? The question itself is wrong. If the knobs were deliberately created, then all the blocks would have these protrusions. So they were not created on purpose, and some knobs are too small for having any meaningful purpose. And look, out of about 300 blocks of stone, one block may have a knob. So what are they? These knobs are actually very common if you're familiar with casting or molding technology. These are called drops in the field of casting. When we melt some material and pour it into a die, sometimes if the material has not fully liquefied, it creates a projection like this. These are common defects, technically known as drops. These drops or knobs reveal something important. Ancient people were not using solid rocks. They were melting and casting rocks, just like how we cast concrete blocks today. In engineering, out of several hundred jobs, one or two will be defective. This is well known. This is exactly what we see here. Out of several hundred blocks which were cast, you see one knob. So these knobs are not purposeful creations. These are defects. The ancient builders in Cambodia definitely altered the natural property of rocks. They melted them and added some other ingredients. This is why these guys were able to build these incredibly large temples. However, I think this is also why these temples were also taken over by plants and trees. In Cambodia, plants somehow grow on these ancient sites, but you don't see this often on natural rocks. The plants seem to grow only on the stone blocks of ancient temples. I think it's because these blocks are softer than natural rocks. Workers at Koh Ker Pyramid tell me that even though they clean the pyramid regularly, removing the plants start growing on these blocks immediately. This gives more insight into what the ancient builders were doing. When we look at more and more evidences, it clearly shows that they were melting rocks, possibly even adding more materials to convert them into geopolymers. This liquid geopolymer was then cast into different shapes and sizes according to their requirement. If you look at my channel, I realize I've posted many, many examples of this stone melting technology. You can see how ancient builders created floating rocks. This is found in the ancient temple of Warangal. Experts now agree that yes, these rocks were artificially created many, many centuries ago, and they were made deliberately lightweight for a specific reason. In the same area, there is an ancient temple called Ramappa Temple. There is a pillar in this temple. It looks quite normal, but when I observed it from the bottom, you can see that it's bent like some flexible material. Solid rocks don't bend, they're supposed to break. These are all clear examples of rock melting technology. But this idea that stones were cast artificially may seem new in our age, but in Hinduism, this is a well-known concept. I often see priests of Hindu temples telling me that stones were created artificially.
This is not available stone. Man-made stone. Olden days people brilliant, they make. Nowadays our knowledge is zero, nobody knows the combination. That is a drawback, not possible to maintain, not possible to repair.
In Hinduism, it is believed that there are herbs, certain types of plants which can soften or liquefy stones. In the Praveen temple in Cambodia, I showed you how perfect arches were created using rock bending technology. I mean, look at the bends in the topmost blocks. This is also a clear evidence of rock melting or rock bending technology. So, what do you think? Are these knobs casting defects while ancient builders were mass producing geopolymer blocks? Is this why we see one or two of these knobs every several hundred blocks? Or do you think the mainstream explanation is accurate? Were they used for lifting the blocks? If so, why don't all the blocks have these knobs? And why many of these knobs are so small that we cannot put anything underneath and lift them? Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section. I am Praveen Mohan. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and also click on the bell button to get all the updates. Please give this video a thumbs up and do share it with your friends. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.